Simon.
Thank you. Me, my observation, yeah. As I already mentioned, the Asian country stand for a bit shy. I don't know when I'm shy. Okay, I think the problem is around.
The balance.
So I don't know how we can handle that issue because most times we don't follow each other.
I mean, the purpose of this catch-up in general, maybe you especially for people to assist us in the future to improve the TCP program. We are going to have another TCP program next year, maybe not next year, but the year after that.
Yeah, after.
So all of these are going to be useful.
Yesterday, there were some people were suggesting that it is too long. But to me, I think the 3 weeks are the ideal. Because 2 weeks would be too short. That is me. But with 3 weeks, and when you benchmark it with other countries, usually it is. Basically 3 weeks, because the first week is the theoretical part, second week the field work, and the third is the you now coming to consolidate what you have learned in the fields. And then the other aspect was this one by site here. I think we need to organize when it comes to field work. A bit inconvenienced. You go to the field, you spend the night there, then you come back. So the check-in and out of the hotel, because the hotel was many. So it would be better to, you get in the 4 days, you go to the field, and then you come back, you set up at once. So that's the only one. Check out from me, but that's what I'm saying.
If we follow that approach, then the number of sites, field sites, will be reduced. We still have a base site. Of course, you can also direct your questions not only to me, but to the my director and representative from the TCP, of course, from Chaika.
Yes. Thank you. I'm Jenna from Uganda. My concern is, in order to do this effect, what we gain from here, the NICE program, is if we can all know each other, the participants that have participated in the TCTP program before, so that when we go in our countries, we can network. We look for one another and we put some bigger projects so that at least we can be seen. Because me, where I stay is very far from my countrymates, so if we go, we may disappear.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have a network for ever since this program started, we get together, maybe we get like a workshop, we can bring out this one very quickly and the whole country will see it and will take it away. That is my
suggestion.
I support that. This is a very good suggestion because it's important for you to work together. Yeah, like the team is very important and it's such a big commitment, you know. So I don't know how we are going to do that because we have all the name list and
usually you have the WhatsApp group. Within a WhatsApp group, usually the training messages for us are communicating with the watch. So that's what we these days are doing.
But I think she course also implying not just the current anyone DCTP program.
Mm-hmm. Even the previous group,
they still have the communication through WhatsApp.
Through WhatsApp.
But it's within certain years, right? It's not like,
yeah, it's
not for the 9 years.
Yeah, but to share, early in Uganda, because we don't have missions in Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
But for the other missions, we have the missions in Africa,
mm-hmm.
but for the other missions, every year, NTCP, we will have a program for the alumni of the NTCP. NTCP together with the DCTP, we will include everyone in the program. So that our missions, our embassies outside, they will invite everyone nearest to the country to join the program. It's not really, it's like this program, it is like the bowling tournament, the high tea, or any. This is simple for the community, just to do the networking between the embassy participants, because as you said before, you now will only have the networking with the current participants,
mm-hmm.
even from Uganda and from the other parts of Africa, but you don't have the networking, the communications with the previous one.
Mm-hmm.
That is where the alumni program takes place in our but.
We, as I told you in the beginning, we encourage you to link up with offices, take offices in your country. You can just report, make a point of this, and you can report to what you experienced here and what you are aiming to do. That is critical.
In fact, for Uganda, we have another grade that we will come back. We are interested and Kai will come up with a project. We want to link with JICA.
Mm-hmm.
It's a serious project, not just networking or MSR, so that if JICA can accept the proposal, then we'll take it back from there.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Thank you. Oliver from Uganda. Mine is about the nature of the course and then the participants that come on board. Recently, in my country, we have a problem of collaboration, especially if you have to tackle biodiversity conservation and ecosystem management. We find that there are different stakeholders, different ministries concerned with this issue, but collaboration is a problem. Maybe next time, maybe you're inviting or nominating participants, maybe you could look at the key bodies. Like for example, you're going to have the Ministry of Water and Environment. Unfortunately, no one is representing like now. So, if maybe from here, I'm from a community institution, my colleague here, they're from Ministry of Agriculture. Even if you have to study something, we have a challenge of collaboration. So if you got at least a participant from every key stakeholder as far as biodiversity conservation.
So this is to do with the selections of participants for the NTCP.
Mm-hmm.
This is not a particular country.
Mm-hmm.
So who decides? How does it work?
Because the invitation will come in from the NFA, from the NTCP. So our missions for Uganda is handled by Kenya. The Kenya will send the invitations to your NFA. When we send the invitations to your NFA, it's already the internet access of the government. It depends on the government, who to nominate, from which stakeholders, ministries and organizations they want to invite the participants from. When the invitations reach at your NFA, it's already your internet because we cannot interview
the
process. And
who you will send, right?
Yeah, this happens not only for this course, but for the other course. When the invitation reach the NFA to get the endorsement from your NFA and to complete the process and everything, such a it took a longer time because this is the generic point we will offer to the whole African continent, but it will depend the officials from the country. But the standard procedure is we will send our IP to your IP. That is the system to change the information system.
Yes, Josh.
I'm George from Kenya. My concern is first of all the training program. To me was very beneficial. The program, the process, as my colleague said, 3 weeks are enough to digest all this and bring out the reason why we actually came away from our country to come and learn. Now my concern is for Malaysia, when the program was being introduced by JICA through the Japanese government, you learned, you started implementing, and you could go to the field and see that these things are working. Now for us, for the last 9 years we've been having participants, what is the effect of the program? We will not want to go and, okay, with all the knowledge that we've gained, then sit. Some of us, the position, yes, you can initiate a project, but the position you are, it has to go through so many processes before it can reach to JICA. Then some of our organizations, the way the structure is, you having a proposal and going direct to JICA and presenting it, you might find yourself on the wrong side. I'm proposing, like, the uniformed KWS, it will be very hard for me from Mount Kenya to do a proposal, because the way we were discussing yesterday, we are the ones who see the problems. And we have that will that we need to come up with a solution. Is there a way through the JICA office, for example, in Kenya, that we can have an idea, do the preliminary analysis of what we want to do on the ground? Then through the JICA office and our organization now at the headquarters, they can push it. And with people on the ground, knowing that Alex is there, the other participants are there, can pull these resources together and fine tune and come up with a project that can actually be done. So that by the next 2-3 years, JICA people from Malaysia can come to Kenya, Uganda and the other countries and actually see that whatever things that we taught these people, they came up with a project and see this is what has happened. There is progress. Because the training is good. We could see it. That is why after so many years, Japanese government would be very proud that we introduced this in Malaysia. They picked it up and look what is happening. Good things all the time. So what is the way forward? Because yes, we can train every year and have so many people want to train. And the effect should trickle down to, because why are we doing all this?
On the ground.
On the ground. Not for me to have the knowledge and then go sit in my office.
Yeah, so you
and say, okay, there's a problem. There's a problem somewhere. But because I'm not the director, I'm not maybe the next in command. There's somebody. I'll go and share with my boss. I don't know how he perceives it. We'll not have 3 weeks for him to see what I've seen.
You probably think that you are trying to overtake his position. I don't know.
Is there a way for him to, like, after coming back from this training, for you to share to your department in a presentation, presentation based on your experience and try to, it's not to sweat, but try to, like, open your eyes or maybe share, or maybe you can give, like, a short time, training or whatever. Is that the way? Like, normally when you return from any training, you share that with your members of the department?
Yes. Yes, but
I know what you mean.
Is that now bringing it into practice? Mm-hmm. The reason why I'm asking this, I think Alex can testify. We've the middle level managers and the senior managers go to different courses.
Mm-hmm.
And the middle level managers, when they are taken to these courses, they are expected to come and
do the things on the ground. But if the senior managers are not through that course, I'm telling you we have a problem. They will not understand what I'm saying. They will not appreciate that this is the right way to go. Until somebody somewhere thinks, okay, we need to bring the senior managers. So that when now the senior manager, oh, this is what Alex was telling me. Let me buy this idea, let's do something.
So,
well, I just advise you, it's what I told you in the beginning. I'm still saying that, yeah, there is a new scheme that Jack Boros takes much. But, you know, that scheme is highly competitive. So, when we select that each one will be taken, which are not taken, it's still the involvement. It's on the commitment to the institution. The institution does not mean that it will come up in time here. The branch of this is also fine, but still, is there any commitment from your government side? Because we have government to do this. We deal with the government. So, that's what I advise you. We just need you get involved with the institution. And also, while you are talking to it, or linking up its general offices into it, that will help your proposal to be supported.
Thank you. I'm Alex from Kenya. First, thanks so much for helping with us. So to JICA, I know they are currently at the advocacy investing portion of their programs. Even now at my office we have a technical project with JICA. And I know once I go back to the country office, then I would wish to what let us ask is I must do a back office report. And possibly what I presented yesterday also for a forum presented the same. And also see where my bosses can take up the matter, maybe to a more high level of the discussions to craft also in a more better way. And see if we can see also see it way to take office. My question to take is maybe just something. Do you do follow up on the participants after the training? Two, is there a window in terms of the interactions between your office and the participants from different countries?
Yes.
Because the people are like, invited to some of your forums locally in our countries, then you can see the opportunities which are there for development and all sorts of integration.
First of all, the forum scheme there's a certain independent scheme to borrow the expedition. That's what I told you. It's highly competitive. Because you have to compete with other expertise. So, but that is one way. But another is like if you have a certain project, wanting JICA project already under within this institution, it is better you also talk with the expert there, JICA expert there. That will be. Because within that project, there could be some certain way to help. That is why, generally speaking, we promote participants from the counterpart institutions into our JICA project. Because it is much easier for you to come up to some activities after the project. But for those who don't have the JICA project, we encourage you to contact the JICA personnel, office in charge, office in charge of the matter.
We used to, as part of the BCTP activities, what we call the fact finding mission. So, the fact finding mission is basically an activity whereby the ex-participants of the TCTV program, after they have participated and gone back to their respective organization, we follow them up by us visiting the institutions to see what they learn, what they're doing. You know, they will then do a briefing in front of the directors or superiors, and, you know, see whether they really apply what they have gained through the TCTV program all the time. And I thought that was very useful. That helped us to a great extent how to design, redesign the TCTV program with you know, so that the dissemination of information at scale from our TCTV program will be more effective in the future. We have had this expanding missions follow-up activities for several, after several TCTP programs, but beginning the last two TCTP, we have stopped this already due to constraint in terms of budget for TCTP. Well, this my personal opinion. Previously, not anymore, but of course we understand completely the constraint in terms of budget. Mm-hmm. And this affected not just this TCTP, but other TCTP programs.
It's actually
when
the projects are really affected, the MFA is more
than that. Oh, the rest, for the government entirely.
To have a new system and everything. But for the fact of the machine, it will depend on the recipient country as well.
That's true.
For example, if you see the point you have a guideline that since the last king died, I think they just like to do the same. And this year they will have the ASEAN, they host the ASEAN summit. For the third one nations, it depends on the receiving countries we want to collaborate with this. Because it's actually 50-50, like what anticipate and try to do in a partnership. We will cover certain area, and recipient countries will cover the recipient areas.
Okay, having said so, however, of course, with the advancements of technology, fact-finding missions can be done remotely.
Yes.
So that can also be done, for example, through Skype, which is FOC, free of charge. This has never been done before.
But
we could
do the
we
possibilities
could
try.
Yeah.
To try.
Yeah.
Why don't we do it in China, you know, in your place?
Yes.
And then get all the probably the eyes, the personnel, then we can set up, you know, communication through your department and also listening to us and to you presenting.
Yeah. Well, this can also take place in the form of questions. Pretty much like after you have completed the program?
Evaluation.
Post-program monitoring, something like that. But we don't know, maybe it is equally effective. That's not that much coming in of
chance. In fact, with regard to the part-time admissions, we are pretty much selective these days. Because we cannot just send the people to Africa, all the way to Africa,
right,
just anticipating that something is there. You see?
Mm-hmm.
We just need a clear evidence that from the training institute, things through the record, that there are some ex-participants quite active,
right,
in Africa or Egypt, and you are keeping the contact with the participants.
Right.
and still they need the help on the side.
Right.
Maybe we may consider that.
Okay.
But yeah. First of all, we just need us to maintain contact.
Yeah.
No, I'm not just saying that you have to go through the serious kind of communication. But
no.
That's why I say WhatsApp group is fine.
Yeah.
You can just communicate each other saying hello is fine to us. But out of it, if you find some exposition with the update, then you can maintain contact and you can book to us. Then we can just consider. It is possible. Yeah, of course, if we can go through the Skype or so, yeah, that's also fine to us. Yeah, some cost and benefit. That's what we are considering.
That is
this.
That was just a thought. I guess we are done. Thank you very much for your participation.
Good morning again.
Is it welcome?
Please have a seat.
Any question?
Anyway, please sit in. Yeah, so. Okay. So this from Southeast Asian countries. Cambodia, Vietnam, Philippines.
Somebody
is in Russian.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Oh, right. So. So, as I was saying with the other group of friends from America, we have had this discussion already yesterday to some extent. That was more focusing on the PCM. And just now, Dr. Mahathir also presented your evaluations about the PCM, where quite a number of you have also suggested some ways how the PCDD, sub-PCDD could be improved in the future. So you may be wondering, what else do you want from us? anything else that you would like to say, comments about the PCDD in all aspects that we have not yet captured? That you know is burning inside you, please just forward them to us. The purpose is, as I said, is to help us improve the future. Any aspect at all, the food, the transportation, whatever you are happy with, not so happy, and other suggestions. You're not offending us, not at all.
Yeah.
In fact, you'll be helping us.
I would say the good thing that I have been faced with is a doing a great questionnaire.
Right.
You're quite open to us. I have been a member of the training like this and already writing that we don't keep us like this, like present what the participants write down. It's a very good thing.